Yo guys, Solitrenaline is back with part 2! More new type forms for every Gen 2 Pokemon! Let's get started right away! So, I believe we ended with Lantern last time, and that means the next few Pokemon are babies! The first being Pichu, and the new type is Ghost! So this is like a reverse Mimikyu case. Pichu got too much attention and didn't like it, so it became scary and a ghost type, so it would be left alone! I think it would be a great parallel to Mimikyu if they did something like this. And the next baby is Cleffa, new type, Fire. Cleffa's dex entries always mention it's star-shaped. And stars are made of fire, so it's a fitting type for Cleffa. Fire Cleffas have a passionate personality. They get excited and pumped up about pretty much everything, and they rarely sit still. And the third baby is Igglybuff, a new type is Ice. I turn its hair fluff into an icy crown, so it's like a little ice princess. Or prince. Despite being shy, it also likes to boss other people around, and it usually gets away with it because it's cute. And you thought we were done with babies? Nope, we've got one left. The classic baby Pokemon, Togepi. And the new type is ground. So Togepi is kind of clumsy because it's a baby. So ground Togepi is a lot more angular, so when it trips over, it won't roll away. And it's a pretty rare form because people find round Togepi a lot more appealing and cute, so people don't bother taking care of ground Togepi. And Togepi can't evolve without high friendship. Nor can it breed unless it evolves, so... But a few of them do evolve into ground Togetic. They don't get the wings a normal Togetic has, but they're highly appreciated by miners and builders for their excellent digging skills. I should have said excellent! Oh, missed pun opportunity. Moving on to Natu. New type is Fairy. Thank you, airplanes. Can you stop, please? I'm trying to record. My immediate thought was to make it more like a peacock, because those look magical and fairy-like. I think it's a breed of Natu that was actually made by human selection, for them to just look pretty, kind of like decoration. And the same goes for its evolved form, Xatu. Natu and Xatu are both pretty immobile Pokemon, and they tend to stand still a lot, so it makes sense that some maybe not too nice people would see them as purely decorative things. And thus they created a breed to make use of them like some kind of pretty ornaments. So these are Pokemon for rich and spoiled people. Next up is Sheep Mareep. And the type I got was Steel. Not surprisingly fitting because of Steel Wool. So unlike a regular Mareep, this wool is very scratchy and should not be used to make clothes. And it evolves into Fluffy. And unlike a regular Fluffy, it actually keeps the blue base fur of a Mareep. And the horns grow to be very twisted. And the more twisted they are, the more respected they are within the herd. And lastly, it evolves into Ampharos, who also keeps the blue fur because I always wondered what it would be like if the whole line had the blue fur. And this Ampharos actually has some wool, because I'm not super fond of Ampharos being a little naked sheep, and I like it to still have some of that steel wool to tie in the steel type. And the next Pokemon is Bellossom. And a new type is normal, and those are always fun and weird to make. But to me, if you remove the plant elements of a Bellossom, it looks kind of like a doll. So I played up on that to make it a normal type, and I kept the colors so it has a light green dress and markings on its head that look like hair. This feels like another Pokemon that was bred just to look fancy to humans. Although, they're in a better position than Natu and Xatu because they're popular among children as playmates. And for the next Pokemon, we have the legendary Pika Blue, also known as Mariel. And the new type is Psychic. And a quick note that I actually posted this Mariel on my Instagram stories, and if you want sneak peeks of future Pokemon, maybe you should follow my Instagram. So basically, Mariel, instead of having an attached tail, it now has a floating ball. It moves around with psychic powers and bounces it in the faces of its opponents, which is really cute. And of course, it evolves into Azumarill, who has several tail balls, so it can throw them at its opponents, and it's pretty straightforward. I didn't change much about the design except the color, but I kinda think that's all that needed to be done for the Mariel line. And over to Sudowoodo, and the new type is Electric. And all I did was turn it into a walking battery, because it kinda looked like one anyway. and it no longer has to fear water types, so it walks around doing nothing. So we're quickly moving on to Politoed, and I got Dark type. So I read some dex entries for inspiration, and apparently the swirly hair on its head is proof that it's a king and it earns its respect among its peers. Which is why my dark type Politoed doesn't have one. It has lost its royal status, and it dislikes other Pokemon and is rarely ever seen making friends. Moving on to the Hippity Hoppip, and I got Dragon, and that's a tricky one. And I can't think of a single reason why Hoppip would turn into a dragon type, but here it is. It's still mainly a round blob with a face, and it evolves into another blob, Skiploom. And of course it evolves into Jumplap, who is the most dragon-like of them all with its long dragon body, which is kind of more like a caterpillar, but whatever. And these are like super rare dragons. They're kind of weird looking, but they're like super rare because all dragons are rare. And next is Aipom. New type is Electric. So this form of Aipom was very recently discovered. A big human rockstar discovered this form of Aipom after having trained a number of his Aipoms to play with him in his band. And this particular Aipom was passionate about rock music from the second it hatched. It can produce sounds that sounds like an electric guitar on its special long hairs on its tail. And it now goes with a rockstar on all his tours as his new partner. And so far, no one knows if this is the only electric Aipom or if this form will become an established form of Aipom. And now it's time for Sunkern! New type is Water. It's based on a seashell, but unlike Shellder, it doesn't open up, it just jumps around on beaches and ponds looking cute. It has a rainbow shimmer on its hard shell-like body, which makes it a popular Pokemon to keep as a pet. Not for battling, because it's really weak. It's like super weak, can't do anything. And it evolves into Sunflora, who is a mermaid-like Pokemon. It's a very friendly Pokemon and it likes to swim around beaches where lots of people gather so it can play with them. And that makes the last Pokemon for this part. We still have lots of Pokemon from Johto left, and I think there are even a few types I haven't gotten to draw yet, so maybe we'll see it in the next video. Espeon and Umbreon will show up in the next video. Evolutions are always fun, so don't miss part 3! Thanks for watching, bye!